student, let us start the class. Today we are going to revise about the chapter addition. Okay, I have taken some of the questions, we will discuss about them. Okay, and afterwards I will upload the questions in the Google Classroom. You can go through it and write it down in your maths copy. Okay, when you write in your maths copy, do write the name of the chapter and the date, and you can write revision at the top also. Okay, now before starting the question, let us recall what are the topics we have learned in the chapter addition. In this chapter we have learned to add 2-digit and 3-digit number. Now in a 2-digit number, what are the place values we get? The place values we get ones and tens. Okay, and in a 3-digit number, the place values we get are ones, tens and 100. Okay, then there are three properties of addition. Okay, the first is the zero property. When we add zero to a number, we get the number itself. Okay, the next is after number property. Okay, so when we add the number 1 to any number, we are getting the answer that is just after the number. And the third is the commutative property. In commutative property, if we take two numbers, if you change the position or change the order, we are getting the same answer. Alright children, then there is story sum. In a story sum, the numbers will be given, you have to make a story out of it, just like a word problem. Okay children, so these are the topics that we have learned. Okay, so to discuss questions, I have taken two questions here. The first is add 37 and 43. So there is 2-digit number, the next is a 3-digit number. So we will do first the question number 1, then we will do question number 2. Question number 1 is given add 37 and 43. So addition we already know, counting the number of objects together. It might be numbers, it might be objects, it might be items, okay, anything. We are bringing them together and we are joining them. Okay, the sign for addition we already know is this sign. Okay, this sign is known as the plus sign. Okay, so the question is given, we have to write solution. Solution means the answer to the question. Alright, so it is a 2-digit number. I'll make the place value chart. Place value chart of how many digit? 2-digit is there. So, ones and tens. Alright, since the number might be about regrouping, so we have to make anywhere place, leave a row to show what are the numbers we had carried over. In addition also there is regrouping, so we have to carry over the number. So what is the first number given here? The first number according to the place value I have placed, 3 in the tens list, 7 in the ones list. The second number is 43. What is the sign for addition? Plus. If the word subtraction was given, then we have to subtract and use the sign minus. Okay, this is known as the plus sign. Now we have to add. We know we always start from the ones place in addition. Okay children, so what is the number here? 7 and 3. So you can add using your fingers also or your mental addition also. Okay, so 7 plus 3, what we get? 10. We get 10. Okay, now which number will come here? The number 0 will come here. Okay, and 1 will go to the tens place. Alright, now in the tens place we have got 1, 3 and 4. We have to add all of them together. So 3 plus 1, 4 plus 4, 8. So the answer is 80. The next question is about 3-digit number. In a 2-digit number, we get place value ones and tens. In a 3-digit, we get place value as ones, tens and hundreds. Okay, so three place values are there. Ones, tens and hundreds. Such kind of addition is known as vertical addition. Okay, one after the other. Now I place the number. I don't know whether it is regrouping or it is with or without regrouping, but I will leave one row here. Okay, because in exam, even though it is 3-digit number, there might be regrouping there. Okay, so I'll just leave a column here. So what is the first number? 245, and the next is 424. What is the sign? Plus sign. Okay. So here also we have to add from the ones place. So 5 plus 4, 9. 4 plus 2, 6. And 4 plus 2, 6. So there is no carryover. But still it is better to leave one column. Okay, children? So these are the question about 2-digit and 3-digit number. Remember, in a 2-digit number, there are two place values, ones and tens. And in a 3-digit number, there are three place values, ones, tens and hundred. Question I have taken is from the properties of addition. Here you have to identify which property is used in the sum. Okay, so let us go to the question number 3. This is given 67 plus 1 equals to dash. One blank is given. Identify the property. So this is a two part question. Okay, so here it will be for a two mark, like number 1 and mark 1 and mark 2, or it might be one mark also, half and half. But we have to write two answers here. Okay, so 67 plus 1 equals to how much? 67 plus 1 equals to 68. So we are getting the answer 68. Okay, this is the first question. And the next question is identify the property. So we have to identify what is the property used here. Okay, we are getting 68, which is the number after 67. So what is the property? It is after numbers problem. Okay, children, so you have to write in this way. So there is two answer here in this question. So what is after number property? When we add the number 1 to any number, it might be 1 digit, 2 digit, what we are getting the answer? We are getting the answer which is after this. So what is the number after 67? 68. Okay, we already know that, because that one we can get by counting the numbers. But if you add 1 to 67, you will get 68. So this is after numbers property. Alright, children? The next question is, name the property of addition. We have to name what is the property of addition. We got, so it is a 3-digit number, 999 plus 0 equals to 999. We are getting the same answer. And what we have added to the number? We have added 0 to here. So what is the property used? The property used here is 0 property. Okay? So the property is 0 property. What is 0 property? When we add 0 to a number, the answer is the number itself, isn't it? What we have taken earlier, 999, we are getting the same because we have added 0 here. 0 is a number, but it has got no value. That means if we add 0 to any number, there is no change. Whether the number will increase or decrease, will become more or less, there is no difference there. It will remain the same. So what is the property used there? The property used is 0 property. Okay? Let us go to the next question is, what is the name of the property 2 plus 3 equals to 3 plus 2? Okay? So 2 plus 3 equals to 3 plus 2, what is the answer? The answer is 5. Okay? You can count and you can check. 2 plus 3 also 5. 3 plus 2 equals to 5. Okay? But have you noticed in the question, the order of the number has been changed. That means the position is changed. 2 plus 3. Earlier 2 is first, 3 is second. Here 3 is first, 2 is in the second. Okay. But does that change the answer? No. It doesn't change the answer. The answer remains the same. So what is the name of the property? The name of the property is commutative property. What is the spelling of commutative? C-O-M-M-U-T-A-T-I-V-E. Commutative property. Okay, children? So here I have taken the three properties of addition. I have taken some example and we have to identify what is the property used. Okay? So this is the class. This is the revision of the addition. In the next class, I will be giving more questions about this chapter. Okay? And what are the things we have learned? We have learned to add 2-digit and 3-digit number. For a 2-digit number, the place values are ones and tens. And for a 3-digit number, the place values are ones, tens and hundred. Here I have taken the three property, after number property, zero property and commutative property. How will you recognize the property? We have to look at the sums, what it is being used. Okay? So this is the class. Okay, children? Thank you. We'll meet in the next class.